Okay, quick overview on isotopes. Isotopes are elements that react identical but are just a little bit heavier. So lithium here has a mass of 6, another lithium has a mass of 7, and a third example of an isotope of lithium has a mass of 8. So you look down at the drawing here, the only thing that's different is that this lithium has 3 neutrons, this lithium has 4, and this lithium has 5. But you notice the electrons are the same and protons are the same. So they react identical to each other. They're isotopes, they behave the same. Okay, here you're looking at the isotopes of lithium. Remember, the mass is on top, protons are on bottom. And if you subtract the two, you can get the neutrons. So take a minute, take a look at these examples of lithium isotopes and determine the number of neutrons in each one. So how many neutrons in lithium 6? And how many neutrons in lithium 7? And how many neutrons in lithium 8? And if you're listening closely, you'll notice the way I'm referring to them, this is common nomenclature for isotopes, is you say the element dash and whatever the mass is. So lithium 6, lithium 7, lithium 8. Play. Okay, this worksheet will give you some help with isotopes. This first column, shorthand symbol, is the mass over the atomic number. And so if the atomic number is 6, we know by definition that the protons are 6. And the mass number, and the shorthand symbol way, the mass goes on top, okay? So if we look at the last part, or if you look at protons plus neutrons, that's a good way to look at this worksheet, as protons plus neutrons equals the mass. So those two columns equal the mass. So let's look at the next column. What's given is 1. We have atomic numbers 1. So if you look at your periodic table, that tells me it's helium. The atomic number goes on the bottom. And remember, protons plus neutrons equals the mass. So that's how we know that the number of protons is 1. And we also know that because the atomic number is 1. Okay? And so the way to write this is hydrogen dash 1. And notice that the mass is put right on top there as well. Okay, here comes the next column. Number of protons is still 1. And so we know that has to be hydrogen still. So hydrogen, 1 plus 1 equals 2. So the mass is 2. So we can write that right here. We can write the 2 over 1. And then on this side, we're going to put the name dash mass. So that's hydrogen dash 2. Next column, atomic number is still 1. So we're still dealing with hydrogen. We know the mass is 3, so if there's 1 here, there has to be a 1 here. 1 plus what equals 3? There it is, 2. Hydrogen dash 3. So finally we have a new element, the atomic number is 2. And look on your periodic table, what has a number 2 on it? Atomic number 2 is helium. Okay, so we're going to put HE there. Put the 2 on the bottom. Now again, because the atomic number is 2, we know protons has to be 2. And then 2 plus what equals 3? And that's 1, so we know how many neutrons there are. And so now we're going to write this as helium dash whatever the mass is. Remember, whatever the mass is, dash 3. There you go. The rest falls in